Hello, and welcome to this series of videos about how to use an oscilloscope. In this first video, I will show you how to start up the device and how to use the basic commands. So let's go. So the first step is to start up the scope. And as you can see, for this tutorial, I use a DS1000E series from Regal. It's a quite cheap oscilloscope, easy to use, and we can learn a lot by using the device. This scope has two channels, whichever first deactivate, and then activate again. So for now, there is nothing connected, but the channels are over there. So the first thing we can set on our scope is a vertical axis. And for this, I will just use channel 1. And you can see we can change the vertical position with this button, also the vertical scale with the other button. You can see it changing over there. So the next thing we want to set is the horizontal axis, and I can change the horizontal position with this button, which sets the offset on time, and also I can change the time scale with this large button. This last part on the right is a trigger. And you can see in orange, I can change the trigger level with the button. At the bottom of the scope, you have the inputs, the channel 1, channel 2, and also the external trigger. So now on the top panel, you have different buttons for different digital measurements. The first of these buttons is called measure. And with this, you can measure different characteristics of your signal in voltage, also in time. The next one is called acquire, and with this you can set the sampling rate, for example. Then you have the storage button, where you can record some waveforms. And I don't want to go into too much details for the last buttons, but basically it is to set many of the parameters of the scope, like the language, the time, and several other parameters. The last thing I want to talk about is these two buttons in the top right corner. So pressing on this one will just stop the actuation and will turn the button red. And just press it again to resume the actuation. The other button, called auto, will automatically set the right parameters to observe both of the channels. So let's try it. It becomes green as well, and then turn back to normal. We don't have any signal here, but usually this button will set the best parameters possible to view your two channels. So this is it for this first video. I hope you enjoyed it, and for more information and other articles and posts about how to use an oscilloscope, you can visit our website at www.useoscilloscope.com. Thank you.